The not so cheap seats, number two. I'll probably lose track of the numbers of these, but number two is, if you had a plan, especially if you paid for the plan, or if you're at a college and your coach is giving you something to do, or your strength coach is, or your conditioning coach, or your nutrition coach, or whoever you want to call it, if they're giving you something to do, unless you have sat down and had dialogue with them and renegotiated what it is that you're doing because your plan has changed, or like meaning your life has changed and your scheduling has changed, you need to stick with the original plan. This seems like a no-brainer, but people do this all the time. They say, hey, I want to hire you to do this, and then they literally start telling you what they're going to do, which has gotten them to where they are, which is not where they want to be, and this is where it gets really confusing. It's like, wait a second, if you're hiring me to help you get to point two or to B, and you're at A or you're at number one, then you're probably going to want to let me do what you're paying me to do. So don't just go change the plan just because you didn't know what else to do. Some people do this with workouts. They do it with eating all the time, like meaning, all right, you're on a nutrition plan, this is what you're supposed to be doing, then all of a sudden you're like, well, I felt like doing this, so I did that. Well, why did you, like, what did you do that for? Now, they might have chosen to eat something else healthy too, but it wasn't something that was planned for. And now we have to adjust, constantly like adjusting in life. But before you make that feel good decision and go off plan, go off schedule, go off whatever the pace was, you're like, oh, I was running and I just felt like sprinting, so I started sprinting. Like, great. But we weren't supposed to sprint right then. So you completely made what we were doing and what we were planning for not optimal. Because, again, like, you distorted from what we were going to do. It's not that we can't do that, but we should plan in advance for it or have a fallback plan for when that happens. Now, this happens also. When it comes to training for sports or conditioning and strength and training, people will be like, oh, I felt good today, so I decided to train anyway. Well, wait a second, this is a planned day off. Well, yeah, I know that. Or like, okay, today was going to be upper and you did lower yesterday. You can't do lower again doing the, like, we shouldn't do that. And if we're going to do that, let's plan for it. Again, this is so important. I mean, I'm not saying that if you feel good that you can't push the envelope, that you can't, you know, deviate, but you should address it with whoever it is that you paid for the plan with, right? Whoever it is that is, you know, your coach in that particular area, it should be a conversation, a dialogue to move you forward. That's number two of the not so cheap seats.